Good morning to you all. Good morning, St. Catherine's Church. Good morning. And welcome. Welcome to you all this Sunday morning. I'm Revd Anthea from Carmichael. For those of you who are new, good morning and welcome. Come on in. Amen. Amen. Welcome. This is our third Sunday in Lent, and this morning we continue in our theme where we've been looking at self-care and what that means for us as we journey through Lent. What does it mean to have self-care in looking after ourselves, in how we are relating with God, in how we are looking after ourselves going forward and taking that time, dedicated time, to see about our self-care. So this morning, Bai Bai will share self-care is essential and what that means. I pray that you all are, as you're journeying through Lent, as you're spending that time with the Lord, dedicated time, as you're praying, as you're doing your devotions, as you're reflecting on what it is he has done for us, leading up to his crucifixion, leading up to the sacrifice that he made for us. As we take this 40 days of Lenten season, reflecting on what that means, I pray that as you're going into your devotions, as you're going into your own time, that it's speaking to you, that you are encountering God and speaking to you about what he specifically wants to say to you about your journey, your spiritual journey with him. So I pray, I pray that at this time, as you all take that extra time out, that you are hearing from God in a different way, through his word, through what you're reading, through what you're praying. You are understanding a bit more about yourself, understanding a bit more about what purpose God has placed upon your life, understanding a bit more about the specific relationship you have with God and how you're growing in that. And as we've gone through the last couple of sermons, if you've missed the last two in the series of self-care, please do go online, the St. Catherine's YouTube channel. Those services are there. You can have a listen and go back and see about the other two elements of self-care we spoke about previously. So let us pray as we are in the presence of the Lord. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this day, Lord. We thank you that we have the strength, the health, and the ability, the freedom to come into your house, Lord, to praise and worship your name with our fellow brothers and sisters in Christ. Heavenly Father, we thank you that your Spirit is with us, and we pray, Lord, that our soul will function through the Spirit to hear your word. Open our spiritual eyes and ears, Lord, to hear you this morning, to hear you in a different way this morning. May you touch our hearts this morning as we hear your word. May we consider our self-care, Lord. May we consider how it is we spend time with you. So, Heavenly Father, we thank you. We welcome you, we thank you, and we pray that you remove any distractions that may be upon us this morning. May we hear you, may we encounter you, may we leave different to how we came in. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Can I please ask you to stand, if you are able, as we sing our first hymn, I am trusting thee, Lord Jesus, which is number 258 in your hymn books if you use them, or via the screen. next hymn is Just As I Am. I'm going to invite Emma to come and join me as we sing this hymn. Emma, come and join me. It's number 396 in your hymn books. Emma's going to join me to help me with this one. So as we've been reflecting on our Lord Jesus Christ, we've been reflecting on our lives, we've been reflecting on how we are honouring Him, how we are fulfilling the purpose He has placed in our lives. But we don't always get it right. We're not perfect. We are sinners. We know this. We don't always get it right. But what we have the privilege to do is to come to the Lord and lay all at the foot of the cross. Give it to Him. So we spend these next moments reflecting on the things that we may have said or done that is displeasing to the Lord, and we place it and we give it to Him. We give it to Him this morning. Compassion and forgiveness belong to the Lord our God. Though we have rebelled against Him, let us then renounce our willfulness and ask His mercy by confessing our sins in penitence and faith. you would join me in the yellow words on the screen. Wash away all my iniquity and cleanse me from my sin. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Against you, you only have I sinned and done what is evil in your sight. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Create in me a pure heart, O God, and renew a steadfast spirit within me. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Almighty God, whose most dear Son went not up to joy, but first he suffered pain, and entered not into glory before he was crucified. Mercifully grant that we, walking in the way of the cross, may find it none other than the way of life and peace. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Amen. Robin will now come and read for us from the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 22, verses 36 to 40, and also from 1 Corinthians 6, verses 19 to 20.
Matthew chapter 22, verses 36 to 40. Teacher, which commandment in the law is the greatest? He said to him, you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, and with all your soul, and with all your mind. This is the greatest and first commandment. And the second is like it. You shall love your neighbour as yourself. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets. 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verses 19 and 20. Or do you not know that your body is a temple of the Holy Spirit within you, which you have from God, and that you are not your own? For you were bought with a price, therefore glorify God in your body. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Self-care. What is this word, self-care? Why self-care? Following the pandemic, many people start to realize how much of their life is spent just doing three things. Three things. Eat, sleep, walk, and repeat. Eat, sleep, walk. That's the life. Nothing else. Eat, sleep, walk, and repeat. But the question then comes as to, what then do we do for ourselves? Many a times we say, taking an evening bath, watching television, getting a massage, or even shopping can be some element of self-care. But it's just more than that. You have to look after yourself. One thing that you always encounter when you're traveling on the plane is that when they give you demonstration as to the safety warnings, what you need to do, and so on, there are two things that they always mention. Put on your own seatbelt first before you put on that for your child. When the mask comes out, put yours on first, the oxygen mask. before that child. Why? Because if you don't look after yourself, if you are not strong enough, you put a mask on a child and then you pass out, who is going to look after the child? The strength of yourself then is so important that it's no longer indulgent, it's necessary. Because the one thing that Jesus did is not just talk about self control. It's not about self-care. He showed us the way. He showed me the way. He teaches you what you need to do. When he had a multitude of people coming to worship him, as they gathered, he took time off, not once, many a times, away from everybody else, to look after himself, to commune with the Lord in prayer. One speech given by Mr. Dyson, one of the CEOs of Coca-Cola, he said, life, imagine life that you are juggling five balls, and you name each of those balls. One of them is work, the other health, family, friends, and spirit. But the one thing that she said there is, of all those five balls, only one of them, if you drop it, will bounce straight back up, which is work. Eat, sleep, walk, repeat. And we all focus so much on work that we forget the other balls. But those three other four balls, if you drop them, they can break. They can get shattered. And this is the foundation of our lives. Your family support, your friends, your health, and most importantly, spiritual maturity. What is the greatest commandment? You should love the Lord with all your heart, all your mind, and with all your soul. All. The second one, love your neighbor as yourself. How will you love somebody if you don't love yourself? How will you take care of somebody if you don't take care of yourself? How will you support other people if you don't support yourself? Self-care, as by definition, is a deliberate practice of paying attention to and taking care of your physical, mental, and emotional health. We are here for a purpose, just as I am, just as you are. You have a purpose. Jesus said, when salt loses its saltiness, it throws it away. If we don't look after ourselves, if we don't put attention to what we need to be, the life today is so interesting that in the old days, you have the house phone, you go to sleep, you forget about it. Now we have our phones next to us. You might be sleeping, thinking you want to know what's happening. But Jesus, he moved away from everything. Drown out the noise. Forget about everything. When I used to be a very active sportsman, the one thing that you imagine when you're in a race is try to forget about everything else and just focus on yourself. Because you spend so much time thinking, is he going to go off the block before me? Will he be running taller than me? Is he stronger than me? While you are pondering over that, he's gone. Focus on yourself. drown everything else around you, like Jesus did. Take a step back and look after yourself. Seek ye first the kingdom of God, and all these things shall be added unto you. Well, like, I find myself a lot these days is the work element in life tends to be taking a lot of my time, and we forget about many other things. Remember the five balls? Generally, it's very common for one of those balls to take priority in your life. Your health, your friends, your family, your spirit. But to get a good balance is what Jesus said. Looking after somebody else, look after yourself, just like you want it to be done. If we don't put in the right things in our own development, in our own self-care, we will not be able to do what we need to do. We can't serve others when we are running on empty. We cannot embody the gospel when our body is failing. We cannot meet our neighbor's needs when we can't even meet our own needs. Maturity in the spirit is not just about the assumptions, but it's about doing what Jesus did. Going the extra mile, making sure that you, your own life, your own self, your own needs are met. So yes, when you just go in for a soak or a massage, or just taking time off from everything else, it's very easy sometimes for people to say you're selfish. You just think about yourself. It's not indulgence. It is necessary. Because if we cannot handle our own selves, then we can't handle anything else around us. One, Jesus also looked at what else do we need. It's not just about saying, treating yourself with things. He took time to stop, to eat. So your physical needs, your mental needs, and your spiritual needs. Pray. It's very easy to say, oh, when things are going bad, just pray. But the Bible is there. It has all the food that we need to meet our spiritual needs. Jesus fed the 5,000. It's very easy for him to have said, everybody go away. But he understood the need for his disciples, for his followers to rest, to take time to look after themselves, to feed themselves. What we put in, as we say in data processing, if you put garbage in, you get garbage out. But if you put good food in, good time with the Lord, you get good output. Your body is a temple of the Holy Spirit who lives in you. And what was given to you by God, you do not belong to yourself. For God brought you with a high price. So you must honor God with your body. It is your responsibility, just as I am, without one plea. Just as you are. That's how the Lord made you to be. That's how the Lord made me to be. We all individually have a purpose. So take time to stop. Take time to realize that you yourself just need a little bit of time to think about yourself, to think about what your body needs to strengthen you for that next bit, to think about what you need to do for the next part of your life today, to think about the job. Don't get stuck in eat, sleep, walk, repeat. Change it. Do something else for yourself. A walk in a park. A little bit of time just relaxing. Matthew, the book of Matthew, if you just go on to the gospel itself, it will give you a good guide on how the importance to look after your body. Your body is a temple which is given to you by the Lord, just as you are. Just as I am. I will leave you with one of my favorite poems, which was by W. H. Henry, Leisure. What is this life if full of care? We have no time to stand and stare. What is this life indeed if we have no time to stand and stare? No time to stand beneath the boughs and stare as long as sheep or cows. No time to see when will we pass, as clear as I dare not in the past. No time to see in broad daylight, streams full of stars, like skies at night. No time to turn at beauty's glance, and watch our feet, how they can dance. No time to wait, till her mouth can enrich her smile, her eyes delight. A poor life, this is, if full of care, we have no time to stand and stare. Take time to notice the things around you, to notice yourself, to bring in Christ in your life every day. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Lord. Whilst I was sitting there, I was reflecting on COVID and the pandemic, as Baba mentioned. And in COVID, I guess during the lockdown, when we were confined in our houses, what happened, I think, everybody started to reprioritize. You had to reprioritize your day, reprioritize your life. And it brought out what we held most important. We started to look at our health. We started to think, right, maybe I should go for walks. Am I eating? What am I eating? What time am I, you know, some of us weren't working, some of us were working from home. We had to readjust and reprioritize our life. And as Baba mentioned, the juggling, I just pictured. Once we put our spiritual selves as priority, bring further up the list, as the first priority, it will handle everything else that comes after. And that's why self-care is so essential. Because if we think about how we look after our physical bodies, how are we looking after our spiritual inner self, inner being? So thank you, Baba. It's a reminder about what we prioritize, how we look after ourselves is key. But most importantly, how are we feeding, nurturing, growing, looking after our spiritual self, our spiritual being. And during this Lent season, that is what we prioritize. We bring at the forefront because we are thinking about how we are feeding ourselves spiritually by spending extra time with the Lord, by fasting, by praying, by drawing into His presence more each day. So thank you. Thank you, Bai. So please stand as we come together to proclaim, to affirm what it is we believe, to affirm what it is, the foundation that our spiritual selves is set upon, our belief. And say it as if you mean it. Say it as if you believe it. We say these things week in, week out, and it almost becomes a ritual. It almost becomes mechanical. But are we actually believing what we're saying? Where is it coming from? Is it coming from our hearts? Or is it something that we've just remembered over the years that we do as part of a Sunday service because it's just something that we do? This is something we believe, and we are stating claim to it and saying together as brothers and sisters in Christ, in the Holy Spirit, this is what we believe. So let us say together the creed this morning. We believe in God the Father, from whom every family in heaven and on earth is named. We believe in God the Son, who lives in our hearts through faith and fills us with His love. We believe in God the Holy Spirit, who strengthens us with power from on high. We believe in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Let's give God a chair this morning. Amen. We believe in you, Heavenly Father. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Amen. Please be seated. We're now going to have a time of prayer. Eileen will lead us through this time of prayer as we unite together as churches, together as the body of Christ, to intercede on behalf of the Lord.
Morning, all. Let us pray for the church and the world, and let us thank God for His goodness. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, you promised through your Son, Jesus Christ, to hear us when we pray in faith. Almighty and eternal Father, we pray for your church today, gathered around the world in thousands of places, from tiny churches to great cathedral, to praise you, to hear your holy word, and to share together in bread and wine. Help us to put our differences aside and to unite behind the great commission of Jesus to make disciples of all nations. Lord, in your mercy. Merciful Father, we pray for a world where people struggle to live justly and in peace. We pray for those who have to search for daily food or walk long distances for clean water. We pray for the food bank that serves your people during the week. And we pray for continued provisions and lift up all those in need. We pray for those who meet oppression and suffering with courage and dignity. May the justice and peace come to them all. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Beloved God, we thank you for the people who sustain us by their love and kindness. Thank you for the people who make us the fabric of our family and community life. Make us alert to each other's need and quick to serve and encourage one another. May our gentleness with each other reflect your gentleness with us. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
And Heavenly Father, we pray for those who are suffering and those who are experiencing the sorrow of pain. We trust in your love for all people and your deep desire for their well-being. And as we name in our hearts those who are in the grip of suffering and pain, help us to pray and act that they may know your comfort and healing, both now and in the days to come. Lord, in your mercy, and we thank you for people who have lived their lives in quiet holiness and whose prayers can sustain the world. Help us to live in the light of Jesus Christ, our risen Lord, as we try to follow the example. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Please stand if you are able as we share with one another a sign of God's peace this morning. God is love, and those who live in love live in God, and God lives in them. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Please do share a sign of God's peace with one another.
Thank you.
He took our nature upon him and was born of the Virgin Mary, his mother, that being himself without sin, he might make us clean from all sin. And we say together, Holy, Holy, Holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. We praise and bless you, loving Father, through Jesus Christ our Lord, and as we obey his command, send your Holy Spirit, that broken bread and wine outpoured may be for us the body and the blood of your dear Son. On the night before he died, he had supper with his friends, and taking bread, he praised you. He broke the bread, gave it to them, and said, Take, eat, this is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. When supper was ended, he took a cup of wine. Again, he praised you. He gave it to them and said, Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. So, Father, we remember all that Jesus did. In him, we plead with confidence his sacrifice, made once for all upon the cross, bringing before you the bread of life and cup of salvation. We proclaim his death and resurrection until he comes in glory. Praise to you, Lord Jesus. Dying, you destroyed our death. Rising, you restore our life. Lord Jesus, come in glory. Lord of all life, help us to work together for that day when your kingdom comes and justice and mercy will be seen in all the earth. Look with favor on your people. Gather us in your loving arms and bring us with St. Catherine and all the saints to feast at your table in heaven. Through Christ, and with Christ, and in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory are yours, O loving Father, forever and ever. Amen. Amen. Please be seated as we pray. Rejoicing in the presence of God here among us, our Saviour taught us, so we pray. O Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. We break this bread, and that life is the light of the world. God, hear among us. Light in the midst of us, bring us to light and life. Christ is the true bread which has come down from heaven. Lord, give us this bread always. You are all invited and welcome to come to the altar rail to receive the body and the blood of Christ. If you would prefer a blessing, please do cross your arms over your chest So I go to pray a prayer of blessing over you. As you return to your seats, if you go down the side aisles, you could also go into the Lady Chapel over here to my left, where you could light a candle, or you could light a candle just by the piano at the bottom as you return to your seat. You are all welcome. Merciful Lord, grant your people grace to withstand the temptations of the world, the flesh and the devil, and with pure hearts and minds to follow you, the only God, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And we say together, Almighty God, we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him we offer you our souls and bodies to be a living sacrifice. Send us out in the power of your Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory. Amen. Amen. Just a few notices this morning. This evening we have our Sunday evening prayer, which you're welcome to join us at 6 p.m. here in the church. On Wednesdays, we have our prayer day. This is the day that St. Catherine's come together and we pray. At 6:30 p.m., we come in church and we pray, or wherever you are, if you're unable to make it in person, we ask you stop and pray at 6:30 for St. Catherine's Church, for your own personal needs, for the needs of the world, wherever the Spirit leads you in prayer. We just ask at 6:30, we unite together and come together to pray. Those have been very Spirit-filled sessions where we encounter God in a different way. We encounter God by praying through the Spirit and really lifting up the church in prayer. Prayer is the foundation and the key for this church. This church is the foundation, is prayer. And we hold everything up in prayer so that we are led by the Spirit, that everything is done in the will of God. Not whatever I need, whatever the PCC field needs, but what the God intends for the will of this church for such a time as this. Amen? Amen. On Thursday, we will have the third session of our Lent course. Now, our Lent course is going very well. We have about 16, 17 people who attend on a Thursday, and we are going through the Bible. And this last week, we went over salvation. And the Spirit really spoke to us that evening. I mean, today we heard about the first two commandments. Love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your mind, with all your soul, and to love our neighbors as we love ourselves. On Thursday, we were looking at salvation, and we looked at the first two sins that man committed. We looked at that in the Bible. And the first two sins, we looked at what the sin mean. The first sin was that God was not glorified. That was the first sin that man committed. The second sin is that it wasn't thankful. Now, when we think of sin, when we think of sin, those two things, would you think that that was a sin? When you think of sin, what do you think of? For me, I go straight to things like murder, stealing, rape, all those horrible, traumatic things that happen in life. That's where my head goes to when I hear sin. So to him, as we learned on Thursday, the first two sins that were committed by human beings on this earth was one, not glorifying God, and two, not being thankful. This is why we all sin, and sin is sin. This is why we all come, we are able to turn away from sin, which is to repent. We are able to confess, we are able to give it to God. So we learned a few things on Thursday, which was amazing. And so I encourage you, it's not too late. If you'd like to come and join us Thursday at 6:30, we will be looking at the second part of salvation. So please do come and join us. Light refreshments are served. We have some soup, we have some refreshments, and we get to study the Bible together, which is a fun, and it's a funny thing. So I encourage you all. So please, can I ask you to stand if you are able as we sing our final hymn? May we praise, worship, glorify God. As we now know that was the first sin that was committed, let us glorify God. Let us worship Him in praise as we all sing nice and loud and from our hearts. Great is thy faithfulness, which is number 200 in your hymn books.
Thank you.
to love our neighbor as we love ourselves. May we continue to look after ourselves and prioritize you, Heavenly Father. May you continue to speak to our hearts, speak to our minds, Lord. Encounter us in ways that we have never encountered you before. Be with us, we ask, in the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. The God of all grace, who called you to his eternal glory in Christ Jesus, establish, strengthen, and settle you in the faith. The blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit rest upon you and those whom you love. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. Please do stay for refreshments and join us next week for Mothering Sunday as we celebrate the mothers that we have around us.